Divas action here on Superstars.
This is a Divas Round 7-1 Ball. Introducing first from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Natalya.
The red carpet hostess with the mostest, Natalya, served as the interviewer. Stars for Sandy Leaf Night, the auction that raised more than $500,000.
From the Pacific Islands, Tamina Snuka.
And her opponent, the daughter of the WWE legend and Hall of Famer, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, Tamina. Welcome to Ringside alongside Matt Stryker. I'm Tony Dawson. It's Divas action here, and two divas that don't get along.
Well, no, Natalya, of course, is very charismatic and a mat-based grappler, whereas Tamina has a bona fide mean streak and can take to the air with the best of them.
Talking about taking to the air, anytime you mention the Snuka name, everyone remembers back to Superfly. What do you expect in this matchup?
Tamina definitely has a gripe within the Divas division. Tamina feels that she, not Caitlyn, should be Divas champion, whereas Natalya is a perennial contender at all times.
Natalya, the submission technician, of course, anytime we think of the Hart name, there are so many legends that have come from that family. The sharpshooter, the weapon of choice for Natalya.
While these may be spawns of Hall of Famers or family-oriented Hall of Famers, they need to make their own names for themselves. That's what Tamina and Natalya are seeking to do.
The strength of Tamina Snuka on display there. You can hear the WWE fans here behind Natalya.
I'll tell you something, Tony Orlando. It just dawned on me, no pun intended, that Natalya's lower body leg strength will certainly be a factor in this matchup.
Natalya, of course, the girlfriend of the great Kali, the Punjabi playboy.
Now, are they officially an item?
Yes, so official that Ashikek Bachchan and Aishwarya Rai, the other it couple in India, has been mentioned in the same breath as Natalya and the great Kali.
Well, if anyone can mention those names in the same breath ever again, good job, Tom.
Bollywood, of course, the prominent entertainment capital that is India. See Tamina Snuka.
Tamina using her height there as a well-placed kick to the throat has now sent Natalya down. Now you have to wonder, if Natalya can't breathe, how can Natalya generate any offense? And of course, the story to this match, this all broke down in the Divas locker room. Tamina was going on and on about how, hang on.
Here's the cover, shoulders down, and a kick out of two.
About how Tamina feels that she should be Divas champion. Of course, Natalya was minding her own business but took exception to some of Tamina's rhetoric. Let's settle it in the ring.
Snuka in control and in command. A mean streak. You have described Tamina using that phrase in the past, and we see Tamina working on the left leg.
You'll notice right there, Tony Shalhoub, Tamina digging her elbow into Natalya's knee. Of course, anyone that's ever twisted their knee at home can only imagine the pain Natalya must be in.
WWE fans getting behind Natalya, trying to motivate the Calgary, Alberta, Canada native. Tamina has been in control, Matt.
Absolutely, the aggressive nature of Tamina is indicative of where Tamina wants to take the Divas division. Tamina feels that there's no cruelty, there's no, hang on.
Stacked up, shoulders down, a kick out of two.
That the Divas division is lacking venom, and Tamina vows to bring that back.
Ooh! Headbutt on target.
Of course, the Polynesians all across WWE history known for their hard craniums, the headbutt, a very useful weapon.
In to end it. Another kick out.
So think of the damage that's been done to Natalya's knee, Natalya's throat, and Natalya's head. These are all the things Natalya's dealing with right now.
Natalya showing the will and resilience you'd expect of a former Divas champion.
Right back to this potential submission hold, wearing down the ligaments in the knee. Of course, you alluded to Natalya using the sharpshooter submission hold. It's a leg-based hold, so Tamina has done her homework.
Back comes Natalya. Trading strikes. Back and forth we go. Samoan drop, and that might be enough.
So the cocky demeanor of Tamina, she believes that she's the alpha diva.
Is it enough to end it? Tamina, no! Where is the resilience and the heart coming from from Natalya.
Well, you just said it, no pun intended. It's the heart. It's what Natalya brings. It's, WWE is in Natalya's bloodline. She will not stay down.
Referee scolding Tamina for pulling at the hair.
Notice right there, Tamina's attempting to go for a signature superfly splash. Natalya still has some fight left in her there, Tony Siragusa.
Look at this!
Ooh, nice.
Natalya with a stunning reversal. Setting up for the sharpshooter. Can she lock it in?
If Natalya can roll Tamina, all the pressure on Tamina's back. This is a very painful submission hold. Tamina clawing for the ropes, the only way to break the hold.
Oh! The strength of Natalya Kroger.
Natalya!
A heart-filled, character-inspired victory, Matt. We saw Natalya show real grit in this match.
Well, it only takes a second for momentum to change, and the universal sign for submission, the tap out, yields a victory for Natalya, and that's what it's all about here in WWE. Tony?
Early on in this match, it was Tamina that was controlling things. The Samoan drop.
That's right, but Natalya's grappling acumen. Notice Natalya sees where Tamina is, moves Tamina back into the middle of the ring. All the pressure on the knees in the back. There's the tap out. Congratulations, Natalya.
Plenty to celebrate. Natalya enjoying her time with the WWE Universe. Up.